Sorry. I have a lot of French people in town. Sorry. Got a big French mafia. Sorry. Wow. Thanks, the Hall of Fame. What a class, 2023. Unbelievable. I have a lot of connection with that class. Paul Gasol, my teammate with the Spurs. Huge rivalry, Spain, France. Dirk Nowitzki. Where's Dirk? Dirk, I went to your jersey retirement. You're a great friend, and Texas rivalry was fierce. D-Wade, we played twice in the NBA Finals, and people don't know that, but he's my little brother's favorite player. So every time he will come to the house and be like, Dwayne Wade, like all the time. And then be like, man, can you stop it? You're my own brother. But we won one, so we're good. We're good. We're good. Becky Hammon. People don't know that, but she's like my big sister. We have a great relationship. Thanks for all your advice through the years. And I'm so happy to go to the hall with you. It's crazy. Coach Pop, I was told that it was the first time that a player and a coach going at the same time to the Hall of Fame, so that's pretty cool. For the rest, yes, I can't get rid of him, it's crazy. For the rest of the inductees, it's an honor to go with you guys in the Hall of Fame, thank you. So, my presenters, Tim Duncan, I started writing my speech last week, and I was trying to think, like, why Timmy so special? Why Timmy so special? Like, it was like I couldn't sleep, you know, why Timmy so special? And at the same time, it's easy, and at the same time, it's hard. So I will start with the obvious. To me, he's the best power forward ever. Yeah. That's the obvious. But me, what I know, he has a special power, superpower with his eyes. I'm gonna explain. He never talked to get the ball. Never. He'll just look at me. And when you're 19 years old, coming from France, it's very scary when Tim Duncan looks at you. I play with a lot of teammates who will complain to get the ball, you know, oh, Bruce Bowen, like, oh, Tony, I'm open. Tony, I was open in the corner, you know, I'm like, but hey, what's up, Bruce? But Timmy will just look at me, and I'll go to Pop. I'm like, Pop, you give me the look. And then Pop will be like, you really look at you? I was like, yeah. If you want a point guard tomorrow, we need to call a play for him right now. And so that's why, to me, Timmy is special, and he's one of my presenters. Manu is unique. Manu is unique. He's the most unique player I ever played with. And he was so unique that Pop didn't even know what to do with him these first 2 years. It was very priceless as a point guard to see Pop's faces after some of his passes. Because with Manu, you have two passes. You have the legend one that everybody will talk about. It was unbelievable. And the one that go to the fans, to the stands, you know what I mean? Pop's favorite. It was a lot of those in the first 2 years. So we had a rough start, you know, with Manu. And a rough beginning, you know, with Argentina too. You know, the Argentina media, they thought like I didn't like Manu, I don't pass the ball enough to Manu. But I never really understand that because Pop is the coach. It's not my fault if Pop calls all the plays for Timmy and Timmy will take all the shots. I'm just the point guard. So I needed an ally, and Manu was my ally at the beginning. So everybody knows that, but I'm gonna say it again. My rookie year, Timmy didn't talk to me my rookie year. And people think I'm crazy when I say that, but it's true. Timmy don't like French people, okay? He doesn't like my French accent. Is it not until I play against Gary Payton, who's one of my favorite point guard. Where's Gary Payton? Where's Gary? Gary, love you. It's not until I play good in my rookie year against Gary Payton, finally say one word. Actually, two words, three words. I don't remember. Basically, we'll be all right. So We're all good now. The little Frenchie, a little guy from Argentina, and a swimmer from the islands. Who knew? We won 4 championships together, and it was an honor to play with you guys. So my journey started with a big dream. I wanted to dream big. And I wanted to go in the NBA, and I wanted to become the first European point guard to make it in the NBA. And I always tell my kids, dream big. And when you say your dream to somebody, and he's not laughing at you, you don't dream big enough. And so when I was in France, they would always say, oh, you're too small, you're too skinny, you will never make it. But I'm the one who's laughing now. I had a great family. My dad is from Chicago. My mom is from the Netherlands, Amsterdam. I'm born in Belgium, but I'm French. So go figure. I grew up with both cultures. I felt like I had the best of both worlds, and it helped me a lot for my journey. To my dad, I love you, Timon. To my mom, she was a health doctor, helped me a lot for the longevity of my career. I love you very much. Thanks for everything. To my 2 brothers, TJ and Pierre. Those guys will do anything for me. I love you guys. To Josh and Liam, my 2 kids, I love the way you are. You have great hearts. I can't wait to see what you're going to do in life. And I know it's going to be great. I love you very much. Yeah, they love the camera, just like Steve Nash kids. Remember, Steve? I watch your speech, to work on mine. Yeah, they're the same. To my love, Alize, thanks for the support. I love the way you take care of me and my kids. And you have a pure heart, and you make me want to be a better person every day. Love you very much. I'm going to say some quick thanks to my French mafia, my friends, my team. Thanks for all the support. Gaëtan, 30 years of friendship. Thanks, man. You're like my brother. MS, my big sis, thanks for always listening to me and being there for me. TT, I didn't have a big brother, but you were definitely my big brother. I will always remember when I tore my ligament and they were saying that my career was done. And you flew 48 hours after, and you were helping me, going to the restroom and everything with my leg. I couldn't do anything. You were always there for me. Thank you very much. Natalie. Natalie, it's very hard to find the words, but the only thing I know is I'm very lucky to have you in my life. Cut Killer, I don't know where you're at. You got to be the one who traveled the most to see me play. I will always remember 2005 NBA Finals, Game 7. Your wife was pregnant 8 months, and you still came. That was risky. Sophia, Hélène, thanks for making my life easier every day. Alexis, Edwin, Mathilde, little bros, little sis, love you guys. Matt, Tina, my board partners, can't wait to make more memories together. Xavier, Mayu, Vincent, Nina, Luciano, Christina, Bill Day, Augustine, love you guys. To my team, Steven Newman, you're the best. Didier Doma, I have no words. Thanks for everything. You mean a lot to me. Bill Braden, 18 years, I don't know where you're at. Love you too. Neil, Stefan, all of my Infinity 9 group, all of my North Rock Partners team, Rob, Sean, Donnie, thank you very much. I appreciate everything you do for me and my family. The Spurs, man. What an organization. It starts with RC Buford. RC. RC, you find me. You find me. And thanks for believing in me. Thanks for convincing Pop to do a second workout. I was definitely terrible on my first one. Thanks for convincing him. And I will not be here without you. Thank you, RC. I love you. And I'll put Sam Presti on the same group with you because Sam was there too with you. Thank you. Chip England, you might be the only guy who watched all my shots my whole career. And it was very scary to me when you decided to try to change my shot to be consistent. And my first year working with you, I made the All-Star team. So thanks for everything. Obviously, I had a lot of great teammates. David Robinson, where's David? David Robinson, you were the original. You and George Gervin, Patty Mills, George Hill, Steve Smith. I can say a lot of my teammate, Bruce Bowen. You are a hero growing up in France. We were watching you with my brothers. You always took care of me, and you always had my back. Michael Finley, I forgot to mention you on my jersey retirement. Forgot. And I told you I'm not going to forget in my Hall of Fame. It's okay, you're on the Maverick side, but remember, you won with us, huh? You won with the Spurs, you know? I will tell a quick story on Michael Finley. He's one of my favorite teammates. In 2006, he decided to come to the Spurs to win a championship, because that's what you do when you come to the Spurs. You want to win a championship. And in 2006, we lost against the Mavericks. So I was like... So Dirk had a hell of a play, and we lost. And I remember, I will always remember, we were in the locker room, and you were crying, and I took that to heart. Like you were crying, and I was like, man, we didn't do it. And so 2007, my only motivation the whole year, it was to try to bring you a championship. And I remember when we beat Cleveland, sorry, LeBron, when we beat Cleveland, it was priceless to see your face and that we got you a championship. Coach Pop, it starts with him. Coach Pop, you're unbelievable. You're unbelievable. I can say a lot of stuff about you, Papo. The way you cursed at me and the language that you used to push me, but I have my kids here, so I'm just gonna keep it simple. At the end of the day, you threw me in the fire. I'm 19 years old. You, in 5 games into my rookie year, you put me in the back in the plane, you call me and you're like, you're starting tomorrow. I was like, really? I was like, did you talk to Timmy? Yeah, because I was still thinking he didn't like French people, so I was like a little bit scared, you know? And Pop's like, you'll be fine. You're starting, and the rest is history. You've always been a second dad to me, Pop. Everything you did for me and my family, I appreciate everything. Thank you, Pop. I love you. To the French team, the French national team, we celebrated... 2 weeks ago, we celebrated our 10-year anniversary of our first gold medal, the only gold medal we won with the French team, and it was a great feeling. I always thought that if I didn't win with the French national team, that my career was not going to be successful. I was obsessed with winning a gold medal. So it's true. Sometimes I wish that Pau Gasol was not born, because I would have won a lot more gold medals, but sooner, but because of you, you pushed me every year to come back with the national team. So I had some great teammates, Rudy Gobert, Nicolas Batum, Jan Mahimi, but my two partner in crimes, Boris Diaw and Ronny Churyev, you made it worth it. You made it worth it every summer. You made it worth it. To the Hornets, I want to thank Michael Jordan. He was my idol growing up. He's the reason why I wanted to play basketball. He was my inspiration. I had posters of him in my whole room. And you know, people always say, never meet your idol. But for me, it was the opposite. It was unbelievable that now I had a great relationship with him and I can call him a friend. So thanks for Michael and thanks for the Hornets organization. To finish, I feel very blessed. It was an unbelievable journey. I never thought somebody like me can experience something like that. So for all the kids who are watching, keep dreaming big. Thank you very much. I appreciate and love you all. Let's have a good night.